In this video, we're going to discuss the technical skills or the technical knowledge areas that a good security architect or cloud security architect would possess to have a great security architect career. And security architects are not hands-on people, meaning we're not going to be configuring firewalls or IDS, IPS systems or touching identity and access management systems. What we are doing is creating a strategy or a strategic blueprint called an architecture to help protect an organization from harm. And there's a lot of different types of security we actually need to know a lot about in order to create a comprehensive end-to-end security architecture for a business. And in this video, we're going to talk about the most critical elements that you need to know for your cloud security architect career or security architect career. Now, the first element is going to be network security. And much of the security, a significant percentage of it, is going to be done on the network. And that means understanding firewalls, what firewalls do, how firewalls work, and understanding the differences in, say, traditional firewalls versus next generation firewalls versus signature type detection versus behavioral and anomaly type and AI type detection of problems. So that's part of firewall security. Having good knowledge of intrusion detection and intrusion prevention systems and how they work and where to deploy them is going to be critical for the architect. Understanding virtual private networks and how to protect them and how to keep them secure is going to be critical knowledge for a security architect. Understanding network access control, how to prevent unauthorized devices, for example, from coming onto the network. Segmenting our network in order to make sure that certain users can't talk to other users to protect our systems. And that's really the main components that are going to go into network security that you need to know. Now, the next main phase of security that you need to understand is identity and access management, which really relates to determining who a user is or who your user claims to be, determining what they're allowed to do, and then keeping track of what they've done. So in the world of identity and access management, you'll have to understand things like role-based access control, which is where we grant users to a specific group and then provide rights and permissions to that group. You'll have to understand things like multi-factor authentication and understand the various forms of authentication that we can use to identify a subject. And obviously, in most cases, it'll be multi-factor, but it could be something you have, like a token or a card, something you are, like a fingerprint or an iris or a retina scan, for example. Or it could be a combination of a passphrase, something you have and something you are. And that would be your multi-factor authentication. And that's going to reduce the risk of any kind of unauthorized access due to bad credentials or someone stealing someone's credentials. We're also in the IAM phase going to be getting involved in privileged account management, really making sure that we super harden or lock down those accounts of people that could do damage to the system. Now, in today's world, we're going to be trying to make these systems secure and still relatively convenient. So we'll be involved in various single sign-on solutions, and we'll be looking for single sign-on architectures to simplify the user perspective. And of course, when it comes to identities, we're going to be looking at all kinds of identity federations, especially in the world of multi-cloud architectures. Now, the next main component of what we need to understand as security architects or cloud security architects is application security. Now, what goes into that? So some of that's going to be secure coding practices that we need to advise the organization on. These are practices like input validation and output coding and secure error handling. And these kinds of things prevent against things like SQL injection or cross-site scripting attacks. Now, we also want to input security in the applications as they're being created. So part of security architecture is coming up with a plan for, say, static application security testing and dynamic application security testing and interactive application security testing. Now, another main focus of the security architect is going to be data protection. So that's going to involve a lot of things. It's going to involve encryption to protect the data when it's at rest and in transit. It'll also involve data integrity management, which comes from typically encryption and hashing to make sure the data hasn't been changed and the data is what it's supposed to be. Data protection will have an access control element of determining who can access what, for example. We'll also be working on data loss prevention strategies and data loss prevention technologies that will monitor and detect and prevent the unauthorized access or transmission of data outside of the organization. And this is going to protect an organization from accidental data leaks, insider threats, or any kind of unauthorized data exfiltration where it's pulled out of the systems. We'll typically have to be involved in some type of development of a backup and recovery strategy to ensure the data is regularly backed up and can be restored in case of data loss, corruption, or a cyber attack. And lots of work on data backup and recovery. And we'll be also being involved in things like data masking and anonymization projects to protect sensitive data by either securing it or replacing it with other non-sensitive data. We'll do a lot of monitoring and auditing, or at least setting up the processes for someone else to monitor and audit systems, where those people are going to track log access, modifications to the systems. And we will be dealing with a lot of compliance and policy management, working with, say, data protections like GDPR in Europe, HIPAA in healthcare, those types of environments. And we're going to have to make sure that an organization stays in compliance and they've got good training for the people of how they handle data, safe data handling, and secure data handling processes. Now, as architects, we'll also be involved in the endpoint protection worlds. We'll be looking at endpoint detection and response systems, which will provide continuous monitoring and give us real-time threat detection on our endpoints. We might put them on our servers, for example, as well as our user workstations, because this will give us some capabilities like threat hunting and incident response and behavior analytics. We'll be able to protect the devices themselves at the endpoint. We'll also be involved in designing a plan for mobile device management, which is really where we're going to build a plan where we can manage all the mobile devices. So maybe somebody lose their phone and we want to remote wipe it, for example. We want to perform an application management to make sure people have the right apps on their systems, not the wrong ones. And we can enforce security policies like password complexity and encryption on the mobile devices. And with that endpoint protection, you should always think about the devices themselves and how we can protect them. So mobile device protection also includes things like antiviruses, but they're endpoints, so we kind of covered it there. And we'll also have to look to make sure we've got very strong processes to make sure these mobile devices can only access what they're supposed to. Now, we'll be involved in designing plans for security operations, things like threat monitoring and threat detection, because we'll have people that are going to be monitoring these systems, and they'll be looking at typically a SIEM system, which is going to aggregate all their logs into a single place and potentially provide some security analytics. And we'll be involved in incident response and management. We're going to be constantly building incident response plans, for example, and procedures. We will be developing a plan for the engineers when they do their vulnerability management, where they're going to be regulatory assessing and scanning systems to find weaknesses in the system to determine what we can do from a perspective to increase the security and patch weaknesses. So that could include things like patch management, vulnerability scanning, risk prioritization. And we will be doing a lot of secure policy creation, which will be enforced by the organization, which will help that organization create a policy, set of procedures, for example, of what people will be doing. And we're going to make sure, as part of the security operations phase, that we're adhering to the guidelines and the auditing practices and the standards that we need to, whether that be GDPR, ISO 27001, NIST, what have you. Now, also at this point, we're going to be gathering threat intelligence. We're going to make sure our team constantly is involved in gathering threat intelligence so they know what's coming at them so they can build, so we can help build mitigation and risk plans, meaning new architectures. Now, the security architect will have to have a good understanding of cryptography, symmetric cryptography and where that would actually be used, asymmetric cryptography, public key infrastructure and where that would be used. Definitely hash functions and protecting hash functions to make sure that our messages stay secure and potentially protecting them with things like salting hashes. We might also need to know a little bit about elliptical curve cryptography, which is a type of asymmetric cryptography that uses high security and small key sizes. And we often use them in mobile devices, IoT, or blockchain. We could be getting involved in quantum resistant cryptography, which is designed to withstand attacks from, say, supercomputers and quantum computers. We may get involved in designing plans for digital signatures, for example, to make sure we can verify the endpoints. So as you can see, there's a lot of things that we need to know about as security architects that cover various aspects of an organization's security. And there's other components that I didn't talk about, like physical security, that are also part of our security architecture, but I covered the majority of the things that a security architect need to know. So in this video, we covered what are the things that security architects actually need to know, the technical skills of the architect. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. If you desire to be a security architect, please join us for a completely free webinar on how to become a security architect, where we talk about what does a security architect do, where we talk about everything you need to know, technical and non-technical, and all the things you need to do to get your first security architect job. It's free, and I look forward to meeting you there live on Zoom. So I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.